For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed on the only name, the only begotten Son of God. This is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, but men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. He that believeth on the Son has everlasting life. He that believeth not on the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abiding upon him. Let me state two great facts. There is a Jesus, and he is able to save. There is no Santa Claus. He is unable to do anything. It is God that beholdeth the evil and the good. It is God that records our doings and needs not check it twice. Because throughout the Bible, Genesis to Revelation, God is a great recorder of men and their deeds, whether they be evil or they be good. And God is able to save the evil. God is able to save the sinner. If that sinner will come to Jesus and put his faith and trust upon the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. Man today looks more for a being of fairy tale, whether it be a Santa Claus or an Easter Bunny, and yet they do not look to God their Maker, Jesus Christ. And even religions throughout the world, though they profess Christ and God of the Bible, their children and their people believe in fairy tales. And yet what we preach out of a King James Bible is not a tale, it's not fairy, it is the truth. And Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. That is a statement that the tooth fairy, the Easter Bunny, and Santa Claus cannot make. They are no such beings, but the Jesus Christ of the Bible, the Jesus Christ that is the Son of God, the Jesus Christ that is God, is able to save your soul. And for you to have your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and by Jesus Christ, you are able to go north into God's kingdom. It don't stop at the North Pole. It goes beyond through the gates of New Jerusalem. He is the maker of reindeer. He's never made a reindeer that has a red nose that glows. And yet God the Creator saw man in his condition, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. For the love of God that you want is that God has given us Jesus Christ that we may be saved, that we may be cleansed, that we may have that gap that is between us and God called sin. And that gap is filled by the Lamb of God, which take away the sin. For all have sinned, and the wages of sin is death. but the gift of God's eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The gift of God's salvation by the blood, by the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world, is not able to be exchanged or brought back on December 26th. Neither will God exchange our souls that have believed on Jesus because we have done wrong. Once saved, always saved by the blood of Jesus Christ. The gift of God applies in our heart that we become children of God by the adoption of the Holy Spirit, by the finished work of Jesus Christ, who suffered and died on the cross according to the scriptures, and was buried, and arose again the third day according to the scriptures. It is not the gift that's under the tree. It is the gift that died on the tree. It is the gift that they put in a tomb. And it's the gift that came out of that tomb alive and well and witnessed by over 400 people and believed by faith by millions more. It is that God that says, go ye all in the world and preach the gospel. Don't bring them a Santa Claus. Don't bring them an Easter Bunny. Bring them Jesus Christ, who is real. Bring them my love gift, signed by God, to all the sinners that will receive it. And we bring to you the gift of God. And what fool would leave a present under the tree and say, I'm not ever going to open it, I am not ever going to receive it, and yet you do that with the gift of God, by the gift of God that died upon a tree to give us life, to give us power by the merits of Jesus Christ. The red of Christmas pictures the scarletness of God's blood that flowed through Jesus Christ, that God has purchased with his own blood, Acts 20:28. The yellow of Christmas, the gold, the deity, the kingship, the kingdom of Jesus Christ and of God by the power of the cross. The blue of Christmas, the heavenly color that you will not ever see without Jesus, because without Jesus you will see a black and you won't even see at all. In hell it's black. There are no lights, twinkling or not. There is no Noel, there is no Yuletide fire. There is an eternal fire awaiting for you that will not receive the gift of God, Jesus Christ, the Son. The green of Christmas is the life that God will give you through Jesus Christ, the eternal life. The eternal life if you're to put your faith and your belief upon Jesus Christ. The dead green, the brown, the burnt up grass, life, trees, bushes, is your dead life without Jesus Christ. The white of Christmas, though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be made white as snow. Purity by Jesus Christ, what you and your religion and your Santa can't do. Your Easter Bunny is unable to give you the power to become a son of God. The silver of Christmas. Silver in the Bible is the price of redemption, as Judas took the 30 pieces of silver and threw them at his priest that could not save Judah and Judas, and Judas went off into hell thinking that the priest could exalt him with money. Oh, the north. The Bible says, God in the north other than that fat man's place of imagination of tales and lies. I'm going further than whatever Santa Claus would ever think to go. I'm going by the power and by the blood and by the finished work of Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. Oh, the tree. Oh, the tree. Shall I dare to open the Bible about that tree? I know some churches that don't want what I'm going to read. The book of Jeremiah. I can open it. If I can open. Jeremiah chapter 10. Oh, how somebody wanted the pages closed. I wonder who that would be. Satan Claus. He watches when you sleep, pervert. He knows what you're doing. He's an imitation of God. God knows what you're doing. Jeremiah chapter 10. Verse 2. Read from the Bible, King James. I know there are certain pastors here in Daytona Beach, they don't want this to be read as they hang it in their church. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen. I'm not a heathen no more. I'm a child of God. And be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them. Ooh, look what Mars Rover's doing. Ooh, look at what their NASA's doing. Ooh, look at the rockets going to outer space. Don't care about them. Who cares what NASA's wasting our money with? How about what God has done for you? What about what God is doing for us? What about the wonders of the Bible from the God that's in heaven? NASA will never find God by shooting rockets. NASA will find God by Jesus Christ suffering and dying on that cross, being buried, and arose again. Dismayed the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them. For the customs of the people are vain, empty, stupid. Nothing. Won't get you nothing. Will do nothing. For one cutteth a tree out of the forest. Do we know somewhere we cut a tree out of the forest? Well, what do we do with that tree? The work of the hands of a workman with the axe. Okay. And deck it with silver and with gold. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, found in Jeremiah chapter 10. But let's read about deck the halls. Let's read about the silver and all that. They deck it with silver, with gold, and fasten it with nails. That sounds familiar. And with hammers, that it move not. They want to make sure that Fido is not going to knock the tree over. They're going to try to keep that tree from the cat from knocking it over. We don't want that tree to fall over on Christmas Day. They are upright as a palm tree. We know what palm trees are. Look at them. But speak not. I've been to places where they had an animated tree. It didn't speak, though they tried to have it speak. They must need be born. You got to carry it. You got to throw it out. When the season's over, that tree is not going to carry itself out.
Disturbing the peace around here.
You're driving on the wrong side of the road.
I wish you would stop.
Be not afraid of them, for they cannot do evil, neither is it in them to do good. There's your Christmas tree, and God's against it. It's an idol. It's an image. It has nothing to do with Jesus Christ. It has nothing to do with salvation. I can tell you what the sexual perversion of religion in that tree will do. for people who don't want to hear and don't know how to drive on the right side of the road. But the way, the truth, the right side is to believe on Jesus Christ as your Savior. All the things and all the representations of this time of season, which is not the birthday of Jesus Christ. Nowhere in the Bible is December, any day of December, any time of December, the birthday of Jesus Christ. If you were to look at a biblical standard of the Bible, scripture with scripture, to study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needs not to be ashamed, you would point to September rather than December. And yet the birthday that is coming up that will be celebrated by all is a celebration. It's a birthday of a fallen God, small G-O-D. And we speak here, we stand here about Jesus Christ, the God, big G-O-D, capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, Jehovah. And there's nothing about him in the spirit of Christmas. And John the Apostle in 1 John tells us to try the spirits. Try Santa Claus and see if he's able to give you love. Eternal love, that is. Not that love is and December 31st it disappears and goes away until you get your credit bill for all the junk you bought. What about the love when that person opens up your gift and they are highly upset because that's not what they wanted? How about when all the gifts are open and that person did not get, of all the gifts, did not get that one gift that they wanted? And yet God has one gift for you. Only one gift. That gift is the eternal life. And that gift is in Jesus Christ, who is God, who is the Son of God, who has the record that he suffered and died according to the scriptures. There's no scripture of Jesus. I mean, there's no scripture of Christmas. You may say, well, we've got the manger scene. That's not scriptural. The scripture is that Jesus suffered and died. They say Santa Claus is eternal. Well, he can't do it because there has to be a sacrificial death. According to the Jewish law, a lamb had to die for the sins of the people, and God has provided us the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. It's not about the birthday of Jesus, and thank God Jesus was born. But it's about the death of Jesus according to the scriptures. The very gospel, the very things we are to put our faith in for salvation rests upon what is said in the King James Bible. If it's not in the Bible, it's not the Word of God. A lot of people like this today. That's the death. And in this celebration of this time of year, what's the last thing you're going to think about but death? Yeah, it's kind of ironic that this is the season, this is the time of year that more people commit suicide. Without love, without hope, without mercy, without grace. Without gift, without love. And they can get that through Jesus Christ. You cannot buy God's salvation. It has already been bought. Acts 20. Let me try to turn there. Acts 20. Let me show you. Acts 20:28. Let me show you the credit card of salvation. Let me show you the cash of salvation. Let me show you the check of salvation. Let me show you the money order of salvation. Acts 20:28. Take heed therefore unto yourselves to feed all the flock over the which the Holy Ghost has made you overseers, to feed the church of God which he purchased. That's a big word for this time of year. Purchase. And the CEOs of major stores and outlets are happy you purchase. You make them have a wonderful, happy Christmas by your purchase. And yet, the church of God which he has purchased with his own blood. How do you get to heaven? You get to heaven by the purchase of God. And the purchasement of God, if that's a word, is by what Jesus Christ has done upon Calvary's Hill. That Lamb of God, that one is supposed to be about this season, Jesus Christ, had in his veins the blood of God. And that blood of God flowed out of his body by thorns, by nails, by whips, by being beaten with fists. That blood of God is what purchased our salvation. That blood of God is the only way that you will get to heaven. You will not get to heaven by your works, for there is none that doeth good, no, not one. You cannot be good, for the Bible says again, there is none that doeth good. All have sinned. There is none righteous, no, not one. So there is the gap between us and God. There's a big gap between us and God. And that gap cannot be filled by religion. That gap can't be filled by science. That gap cannot be filled by whatever you want to fill it with. Whatever man can think of. Man cannot build a bridge to God. It's impossible. And yet God has set forth a bridge. And to get to that bridge, there's a detour. And the detour brings you to a hill on a mount outside of Jerusalem. Not in Jerusalem, but outside Jerusalem. Outside the city gates, Hebrews says. And that detour brings you to a cross, to a tree. It's not a pretty tree. It don't have lights on it. And they don't twinkle. They're not big bulbs, but that light does, that tree does have a light. And the one that's on that tree says, I am the light of the world. It's one bulb. It's one light. And that light is Jesus Christ. That light that hangs on that tree is God manifest in the flesh, that we may have eternal life.
Amen,
and Satan has you imitated with colorful lights on a tree. That's an imitation of what God has offered to us, a salvation. That's an antichrist. People think about the antichrist. John speaks about there are many antichrists. There's one bulb and there's one light that God will bring you to, and we're bringing you to it right now. We're bringing to you God on the cross, the light of the world. And I read about that in John chapter 3 when we began. And you're fascinated by lights, Hollywood lights, television lights, my phone lights, red lights. And yet you don't want the light of God the Son, God the person, God the sacrifice. You don't want that light. It's not a fascinating light. It's not a beautiful light. It's a Jewish light. There's no beauty that we should desire him, the Bible says, Isaiah. And yet he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. He's a broken light. A light that you would unscrew and throw in the garbage and put with a new light. That light of God giving us life. And life eternal. Oh, the imitation that Satan has of this world by God in Jesus Christ. But when you come to Hill Calvary and you come to that tree, on it is God. Nailed in the hands and the feet. And a crown of thorns. You say, preacher, you're talking about Easter. No, I'm talking about a babe in a manger that was born and knew when and where and how he was going to die for man. And he died for man from his birth. It's all the gospel story. If it wasn't for the birth of Jesus, we would not have the death of Jesus. We would not have salvation. We would be in the ways of hell right now without Jesus. And without Jesus, you be in the ways of hell. He that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abiding upon him. And you need not, for you have heard that Jesus saves. Upon that tree is God. And they watched him. And they mocked him, as you do in Daytona Beach. They mocked God. You mocked God too. Shame on you. Shame on them. Shame, 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 shame. Use some coal. How stupid to get someone coal when it's very expensive and very reliable. God will give you a coal if you don't trust in Jesus. And what do you do with coal? You throw it into the fire. Coal is the gift of bad children. You are bad children for not believing in Jesus Christ. Into the flames you go. Without being consumed. Black coal goes into a black hell for all eternity. But those that receive get gifts. Those that receive get life. And that life is in Christ. That gift is Christ. Romans 6:23. The wages of sin is death. But the gift of God's eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Are you thanking God right now? Hey, there's no rain right now. People are coming and buying your products right now. Maybe God just held off the rain so you can get some gospel. Maybe when we leave, the rain will come back. I don't know. I prayed, been praying that there be no rain that you might hear the gospel. And the gospel is that Jesus is able to save your soul. Anything else will get you to hell. Oh yeah, by the way, my wife just said something very interesting. For those that do not believe on Jesus, do not celebrate Christmas. Go to work. No, put it all in the garbage can, because if it's about Jesus, don't celebrate it. That's also words of a wise Jewish man I knew. He would say, why would I get Christmas off? I'm not even a Christian. Neither is Christmas Christian. There's a big difference between Christmas and Christian. But since the education system today can't teach you nothing but how to have sex and worship the image, you're not going to know spelling. And I would really throw you off if I write Christian and Christmas in cursive. Send you all ancient alien writings. Christmas, Christians, is not a Bible doctrine. There is no Santa Claus. There is Jesus Christ. How's that? I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, because it is the power that saved my soul. Santa did nothing for me. Everything that Santa gave me is in the garbage dump or on the flea market table making absolutely worthless price of money. And believe me, Santa was good to me when I was a child. But if I died without Jesus, I would have been in hell. Thanks to a non-man who has a feminine name. Santa is Spanish for miss, woman. You got a cross-dressing person breaking into your house, stealing your cookies and your milk. Teach that to you. Oh, yeah, that's right. That's what America believes. That's exactly what America is teaching today. There's no gender. I'll tell you what Jesus Christ was. He was a male of the tribe of Judah. And that male of the tribe of Judah hung on the cross naked for all the world to see. You can't even see Santa. You will never see Santa, the tooth fairy, the Easter bunny. But if I were to die right now, be absent from the body, present with the Lord. If the rapture would happen, and I've died before that, I will go to the clouds with my brethren only. And from the clouds where my brethren are, I will see Jesus in the north, according to the scripture. And he'll have no reindeer. And he will not have a red nose as a drunk. Drunkards have red noses. And it's not Rudolph, it's Jesus Christ. And he's coming to town. But oh brother, when Jesus comes to town, at the end of these 7 years of tribulation, he's coming back as a lion, not as a reindeer. His garments will be red with blood, but not his nose. You do know the Bible tells us what Jesus Christ is going to look like when he returns in vengeance and anger. When that baby grew up that laid in that manger, shall I tell you the lie that the wise men did not visit Jesus when he was a baby? That's a lie too. But Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Let me show you who the liar is. John chapter 8. Again, if I can turn there. John chapter 8. Got no Satan music today? Amen. We'll get the gospel. John 8:44. I almost read you 7:44. Ye are of your father the devil. Ooh, Jesus. No wonder they wanted to shut Jesus up. A guy preaches just like Jesus does. Calls us the devil. Tells us we're going to hell. Oh, make me pray. Oh, preach more. Love Jesus. And the lust of your father will you do. That's a... Jesus. He was a murderer from the beginning. And abode not in the truth. Because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, Santa Claus, Easter Bunny, Tooth Fairy, join this church, believe on Mary, give money, go to this church, baptism, believe on this science, don't believe that, believe this, don't believe that, be a good little boy and girl and you'll get a present, leave your tooth under the pillow. If he says a lie, he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. Satan is the liar. God, Jesus Christ, is the truth. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. It is up to you to bring your children to Jesus. Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me, not Santa Claus. You are going against the scriptures. Let's bring the kiddies to Santa Claus. That's anti-scripture. Bring the kiddies to Jesus, and he'll do them better. They may get a temporal gift, but Jesus' office is an eternal gift. A wonderful gift. And a gift that I received in April 1987, and I still bring that gift. That gift is still alive today, and I offer it to you. Believe or the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. It's that simple. There's no complications. If God has given salvation, it's your own complication. It's your own believing in Satan, that Satan will not lose you to God. Satan's last request would be to have your name in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Isn't that the code? The musician?
What? When the eternities have come, when all the dust has settled, and all the judgments have happened, you will be in the lake of fire that burneth forever, because today you have rejected Jesus Christ as your Savior. Tomorrow you have rejected Jesus Christ as your Savior. And you have heard, you have been taught what God expects from you. God expects you to believe on Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life, to have access to Him. When everything is settled, and inside the walls of New Jerusalem will be gladness, joyfulness, mercy, and grace by all those that put their faith upon Jesus alone. Yeah, they went to church, but that didn't save them. Yay, they were baptized, but that was not their salvation. Yay, they gave money to the church, to offering, to missionaries and other things. Yeah, but that wasn't their salvation. They were good people, tried to be good people. That wasn't their salvation. Their salvation rests upon the gospel that Jesus died for sinners according to the scripture and was buried and arose again the third day according to the scripture. That's how it got into heaven. I am not going to walk up to God and say, God, my religion was better than Jesus. Depart from me, ye workers of iniquity. I never knew you. Oh, you want to talk about being offended? Imagine God telling you to go to hell. I'm offended. Oh, well, go jump in the lake. You heard the gospel. I sent my preacher. I'll even go so far, the book of Psalms and Proverbs says that God will laugh at you. And that will be no joke. When you produce all your causes and your works and to have God laugh at you. And to say, depart from me, you workers of iniquity, I never knew you. At that moment, you won't get scared in your boots. That rich man in hell wasn't scared. You'll go off in the lake of fire that burns forever, angry, shaking your fist at God still. And maybe even thanking God that where they're going, there is no God, there's no Jesus, no Bible, and no more preaching. But the rich man in hell, though as unrepentant he was, unsorry that he was, had a couple requests. He wanted the world to still serve him, telling Abraham what to do. Well, he had some nerve, like American. He demanded, oh, give me just a drop of water for my tongue. That's one of the requests. Another request is, unthinking of lost sinners who have family in hell today. We all do. Sorry to say, but we do. Family and friends in hell. That lost man, that rich man in hell, said, Abraham, if you can't have a ghost or a zombie come out of the grave, that's what he said. You call them zombies. If You cannot have a dead man come to my family. Can you send a preacher to my brethren that they may preach the ill fate of this place called hell? That you may not like the preaching of hell, your lost family does, if they know what's going on. The man in hell says, send a preacher and tell them about this place. Jesus, before he ascended to God's right hand, says, go in all the world and preach the gospel. There is something about hell that Jesus preached more about and how not to go. Three and a half years thereabouts, Judas walked and talked and had fellowship with Jesus, and he still died and went to hell. What better church could you belong to but the church of Jesus? Approximately 30 AD to 33 AD. What better church to have God as your pastor? And he died and went to hell, Judas. Church is not. That dying thief on the cross had no opportunity to be baptized. And yet, Jesus said, today thou shalt be with me in paradise. How's that? How is that when the one that said, I am the way, the truth, and the life? Your church can't say that. Your pastor cannot say that. Your pastorette can't say that. Your priest cannot say that. Your whatever cannot say they're the way, the truth, and the life. Your works cannot testify of you getting access to the Father. Your goodness cannot get you to the Father. Jesus said, I am the way. There is no other way but through Jesus, the door, the life, the shepherd, the water of life.
Again. Shoving down everybody's throat, aren't
you? No, preaching.
Why don't you go up to Capitol Hill and preach those Republicans that have been corrupted so bad?
This is the ministry right here we have. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. There is no other way but the way of Jesus Christ.
Hey, do you know what Citizens United is?
Jesus Christ.
Why don't you go to Capitol Hill?
Is the way, the truth, and life.
Go up to Capitol Hill and do something that's good for the country.
I am.
These people are all out here. It's nice and quiet. It's a beautiful day. And you're shoving it down their throat.
Shut up.
Why don't you go and find yourself a church?
And now
why don't you go get yourself a church?
I got one.
Like a grown-up, and quit being a child and shoving your stuff down people's throat.
Here's anger.
Here's anger.
Peace.
Here's your big mouth with a goddamn amplifier.
Ooh.
Fucking moron.
Nice.
You're turning people off, dude. Doesn't help.
Look at what you just did.
Now shut up, you fucking big mouth.
Ooh.
You're the big mouth.
Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. That is your only access to get out of hell. In order to get out of hell, you got to pass by go, and the go is when they go ye into the world and preach the gospel. Mopoli has it wrong. They say, go straight to jail, don't pass go. The Bible says, go in all the world and preach the gospel, and when you hear the gospel, you receive the gospel, you will not need to go to jail or hell. When you stop at the preaching and believe, I thank God my voice can be amplified for all to hear that Jesus saved. That guy gave a wonderful testimony. my big mouth of Jesus Christ can be heard. What are you going to do at the judgment of God?
I didn't know. I had no idea.
Roll back the tapes, Gabriel, Michael, whoever, of that loudmouth. Unless that man repents of his attitude towards God and puts his case upon his own soul and not Capitol Hill, he'll stand before God as a sinner, as many on Capitol Hill will do. And believe it or not, people, there are people I know in Washington, D.C. doing the same exact thing I'm doing today. So, God has that covered. God has looked down in heaven and he's picked this little spot, Daytona Beach, the farmer's market, and they say, here's the gospel. I love you people enough that I'm going to send a loudmouth preacher that you may hear about my son. And how you may be saved. And how you may come to my abode. How you may become one of my children by that preacher preaching Jesus. How's that? Do we get applaud for God? I'm not ashamed of the gospel. The Bible says the angels rejoice when one sinner repents and gets right. Over 99 just people. You can't come to God just. You got to come to God as a sinner. And believe me, you're a sinner. Let's spend some time with your parents or your spouse or your children or your boss or your neighbors. We'll find out somewhere along the line you're a sinner. How about the first commandment?
Well, I keep the commandments.
Very first commandments, keep God first all the time, every time, every time. Even I fail that one. First thing I did this morning, I woke up, oh Lord God, please let me get some more sleep. I didn't think about God, it's all about sleeping. I failed. I'm a sinner. And yet by the blood and by the testimony and by the merits of Jesus Christ am I saved. There's no way I could save myself. Never mind others. Never mind others. The love of God, which many don't believe, is the fact is he has a loud mouth preacher that preaches the gospel. And a man that will tell you the truth. That will not lie to you so he can get people to like him. I'm glad that man got angry with me, because that's in the Bible. Do you realize the riot that Jesus caused? Because he did good. I'm not good, I mean Jesus. And when I stand up and tell you that Jesus Christ is better than Santa Claus, that's the truth. When I stand here to tell you your great church can't save your soul, is not Jesus the way, the truth? When I tell you what you believe is going to get you to heaven outside of Jesus Christ, that will not make it. Your belief in not in Jesus Christ is to make you go to hell. That is the truth. That is the love of God that I am telling you to repent and to turn and come the way of God through Jesus Christ. That's love. You don't like my amplified voice? For God, my mom didn't like it growing up. I drove her batty. But she's saved now and she enjoys what I do. I bet you she would sit here, some things, I would say amen. Maybe not today's subject, but she needs to grow. It's all about God. And many don't believe in God. Many don't want to have anything to do with God. I lost maybe three quarters of you when I say it's all about God. And some of you say, well, I believe in God. The Bible says, so do the devils, and tremble. The devils are trembling and you will not. That's a kind of interesting fact. But let's step above... No, that's the wrong way to say it. Let's step on the next realm of God. The realm of Jesus Christ, who is God, the Son of God. Now, I just lost another 10%. Many don't believe in God. And many that don't believe in God sure don't want to believe in Jesus. And yet, oh, preacher, I believe in God. Preacher, I believe in Jesus. And Paul wrote to the most carnal church to tell them that there's another Jesus. You may not have the biblical Jesus. That another Jesus will not get you to heaven. Paul says that there's another spirit. Christmas is one of them other spirits. It has nothing to do with the Bible. Oh, there he goes again. Take a red pill. That'd be good. And that there's another gospel. Paul warns the church at Corinth. There is another Jesus. There is another spirit. There is another gospel. They are not able to save you. And in the same chapter, he tells you that Satan has his ministers. And many of them have an 800 number on their belly. Give us prayer and money, we'll throw the prayer in the garbage and take the money. Their hymn is cash, check, or money order. My hymn is nothing but the blood of Jesus. Big difference. Imagine a woman preacher preaching, and the Bible says a woman is not to usurp the authority in the church. I just lost another 5%. I lost you with God. I lost you talking about Jesus. I lost you kicking Santa Claus, and I just really got you when I said women preachers. And yet you won't read the Bible. Jesus only is able to save your soul. It's not leaving this sin for another sin. It's putting your faith and trust in Jesus Christ, who is able to save your soul. You do not get to heaven by good intentions. That's a good idea. Can I get this A?
Last page, here.
Merry Christmas.
Use that any way you want it.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
You have a good day.
Yeah, you got spreading the word, that's the main thing.
Amen.
But you know, the Jewish people, they because it's the Old Testament, they think you're going to get to heaven by good works.
Yeah.
Well, feed off from each other.
God just found me a wonderful ministry that goes out with the gospel to the Jewish people in Israel. International. That's a good name. Finally, all these years I've been praying for to reach out for Jews, finally got me some. And I put right in the thing, this is only for the gospel, for Jesus, no entertainment, no nothing like that. And that's, and they're bringing me news now that there's a war going on over there. The media ain't speaking about it.
The Philistines is powerful, you know, yeah. Back in the day. Now, who's the Philistines today? Is that the Palestinians?
I have to do more work on that. They're in the same area, I'm going to say that.
Yeah, I think
the PLO is the same area, but, yeah. I mean, are they the offspring?
I got you wrong.
All right. Have a good day now.
See you in February.
Yep. All right. I love how God did that. You blankety blank blank blankety blank blank and...
Someone comes and blesses you. Always happens.
The question is, and here's a very important question, and answer it among yourselves. If I were to die today, right now, where I am standing or I am sitting, right now is my last breath. Honestly and respectfully, where would you say you be? With hope. With insurance. No, I don't know. All right, I don't want to hear. I think I'll be in heaven. Can I read you another scripture? I gotta find this one. It's 1 John. I don't know everything. 1 John 5, I believe. I can't fight it, and I'll plead my innocence in the blood of Jesus Christ. I'm looking. Oh, if I had my other Bible, I know right where it would be. I'm still looking. See, I'm not perfect. Oh, shame on me. I am in first half. Okay, make sure I'm in the right place. Wing is 4. Here's what good one though, not the one. We love him because he first loved us. That's been perverted in the Bibles. Ah, here it is. All right, here it is. 1 John 5:13. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that you have eternal life, that you may believe on the name of Son of God. Now my question is, do you know without 1% doubt, 0.0000009% doubt, that if that last breath has already happened, while I was looking for the scriptures, you know where you will be. I know exactly where I'll be. And if your answer foolishly is, well, I'm going to hell and I'm going to have a party with my friends and all that, the lights are turned off. Because the Bible says Jesus is the light. And if you don't want Jesus and you're not going to get Jesus and he's the light, hell has no light. Even little twinkly ones. You'll be in pitch darkness with devils under your bed. If there's a bed. It ain't monsters under the bed, it's devils. How dare we send our mothers, hey, Mom, go get that monster. Nice children. Honor thy mother and father. That's a sin. Mom, go get the monsters. You're not honoring your mother. The light is Jesus Christ. Would you like a little drop of water in hell? You won't get it. Jesus said, I'm the water of life. This is what the rich man. Oh, will you go send Lazarus, the resurrection? Well, we can't do it. But Jesus Christ is the resurrection. Everything that the rich man, I almost put Lazarus now. Everything that the rich man wanted is in Jesus Christ. Isn't that interesting? Lord just showed me that now. I like that. What's your devil showing you right now? That's what he's showing you. Look like an idiot. I'll take pictures of some of you people and then sell them back to you. email them to friends at work, how you react to the gospel. I'm just free-flowing. I'm just enjoying preaching the gospel. Man, there's no interruptions, and you people are, I know you're listening. You can't not avoid my voice. And such a beautiful day, and if God's answering my prayer by holding off the rain, you're getting more business by the preaching. You'll be more condemned by not believing. And there's nothing more about Jesus. It's all about Jesus. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the salvation. How about boast about Jesus for once? Let me tell you about the miserable child I was. And I was miserable to my mother. I was miserable to others around me. I was a wicked sinner, and I can't even tell you some of the sins. I'm not going to confess them either to you. They're all in the blood. Everything I've done since April 21st, 1987, how wicked and they were, how rotten I was, how terrible I was, is under the blood of Jesus. I would be ashamed for God to put a video of what I've done. The assurance that I know I'm going to heaven. I would love to have God put a video now of my sins before I was saved. But you just said, wait a minute. You would be ashamed. Because my sins today that are under the blood, if you were to look at my sins before I was saved, it'd be pictured upon a man on a cross, God the Son. And if you knew me in New London, Connecticut, you would say, I know. And God says, what sins are you talking about? Now, isn't that a wonderful, matchless God? All the filthy language, all the stealing, all the rebellion, all the not thinking of God, all the religion, all the filth. That's not even a bad enough word. Is all under the blood of Jesus Christ. It will never be the day of reckoning for me again. I'm saved now. I'm a sinner. If the Lord came right now, or if I were to die right now, the sins that are under the blood will never, ever show up again. Ever. When God forgets, boy, He forgets. Is there anything that God cannot do? He cannot remember our sins under the blood. Now, I'll call to question my sins that I plead under the blood, and I didn't really mean it. I enjoyed it, but I'm not sure about those. But the sins right now active in my life that I had not pleaded the blood of Jesus Christ, they're going to stand trial. They're going to be burnt up in ashes as wood, hay, or stubble. I'll lose a reward, I'll lose a crown. But I'm still saved. Imagine you who do not have the blood of Jesus Christ, when at the judgment it is all chaotic loss. You have no hope. There is no hope in religion. You say, don't you have a religion? Absolutely not. I have Jesus. God manifested in the flesh. Jehovah's Witnesses have a religion. They have a Jesus that is not God. Catholic is a religion. They have a Jesus that you can eat. Cannibal.
Amen.
The Jewish people do not have Jesus. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. As much as that train is coming, so is Jesus. Every minute you look at that clock, and we're coming closer and closer to what God says is going to be what we call the rapture. The calling home of the Christians. This world is not my home. I wish the Lord would call me now. But, Paul said, it's much to be good with the Lord, but it's much better to, and I'm misquoting that verse. Oh, I love preaching the gospel. I love talking about Jesus. I just love Jesus. And not that way, you pervert. I love him because he first loved me. You can't find that in the NIV. Amen. I can't say it. We love because he first loved. Now, that's so stupid. Shame on me for getting that. See, I'm stupid at times. I'm a sinner saved by grace. I'm not perfect. But God's able to use. Some of you are so holy full of baloney. You don't even see what in front of you is being played out by the Bible. Man, if you took the Bibles, if every Bible is opened by Christians today, and there'd be a dust storm in Daytona Beach. Be gagging. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. I think she doesn't like it. She hasn't been here since the whole time, except for doing business. One day you're going to meet God. Prepare to meet thy God. Meet him on the side of Jesus Christ. Meet him against Jesus Christ, and it's hell. I don't know if I said hell or not. I hate to preach all day and not mention hell. Don't go to hell. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't put your faith in Satan claws. And if Santa Claus, which means woman, is married to Mrs. Claus. Uh-oh. You got a cross-dresser married to a woman. You don't know what they are. But I know who Jesus is. He's my Savior. He's my God. He's my hope. And by him, to God the Father, I am a son of God. Glory to God in Jesus in the highest.